Thanks for a wonderful dinner, Lucy.
You're welcome.
Swell. And Ricky, thanks in advance for dinner in the theater on my birthday. That's a wonderful present.
You're welcome.
Hey, Fred, you know a present you can give me sometime?
What?
You can fix that leaky faucet in the kitchen.
Oh, how long's that been leaking again?
4 months now.
Oh, don't worry. I'll get around to it in due time.
Oh, swell.
Come on. Good night, Rick.
Good night, honey.
Good night, Rick.
Good night,
honey. Good night, Fred.
Okay.
Good night. Oh, honey, I'm real tired. I think I'll go to bed, huh?
Okay, I'll be right in. Fred.
Now, where's that little old leaky faucet?
At this hour?
Well, it was on my mind. This is just an excuse to get away from Ethel.
Oh.
Will you do me a favor?
Sure, Fred.
I want you to buy Ethel's present for me.
Oh, sure, I can. But why don't you want to do it?
Well, she doesn't seem to like the presents I buy.
What makes you say that?
Well, I've been buying her presents for 26 years now, and after I give them to her, I never see them again.
Well.
You buy her something real nice, will you?
With this?
Well, all right.
Okay, did she give you any hints about what she wanted?
Well, she did say this morning she needed a new toaster.
Oh, Fred, women don't like practical gifts like toasters. They like something that's feminine and fun, you know, a gifty gift.
Well, I'll leave the whole thing to you.
Oh, all right. I'll go shopping tomorrow. I'll get her something real pretty, huh?
Thank you, honey. Good night.
Good night.
Forgot my ring.
Hey, as long as you're here, how about fixing the faucet?
At this hour? Are you crazy? See?
Hey, Ricky got tickets for Over the Teacups.
I don't believe it.
He did. Go on up and see him.
Here I go.
Ethel!
Yeah?
Hi, I thought I heard your voice out here.
Guess what play Ricky got tickets for?
What?
Over the Teacups.
Over the Teacups? Oh, that's the biggest hit in town. How did he do that?
Well, he said he had to pull a lot of strings, but nothing was too much trouble for your birthday.
Oh, he's a dear.
He's a real Cuban doll.
This is going to be the best birthday of my whole life. Dinner and a hit play.
Oh. What's the matter now?
I haven't got a thing to wear.
Oh, come now, Ethel. Surely you must have something. Well, I got a dress that would do, but my coat's so tacky.
What coat do you usually wear?
Yours, but you're going.
What about that gold lamé jacket of yours?
You mean that green lamé jacket of mine? Tarnished? It's tarnished.
Maybe you can get it dry cleaned.
Or I could polish it.
You wouldn't believe what that old coat looks like. I'll show you. You know how many years I've had it, anyway.
Uh-oh.
Hey. What's this?
What's what?
This. Oh, it must be Fred's present to me.
How do you know?
He always hides them in the closet. Must be something to wear.
Well, Ethel, aren't you going to peek inside and see what it is?
No, I want to postpone the bad news as long as possible.
Well, Ethel, maybe Fred got you something nice this time. Let's look.
Well, all right. Maybe if I get the initial shock over with, I can act pleased when I open it in front of Fred.
Yeah.
Well, he's done it again.